Hi, welcome. I'm Jill, and today we're going to be talking about naming conventions and tags in LaunchDarkly. When beginning to create feature flags, it's important to decide on a naming convention that is useful, understandable, and consistent across your organization. It's also recommended to use tagging in LaunchDarkly to organize flags, delegate access, and create customized dashboards. Using a standard naming convention and tags will drive clarity and simplify use of the platform as you scale your LaunchDarkly implementation across teams. In this video, we'll walk through best practices for naming feature flags and creating tags. Key considerations when naming feature flags include purpose and behavior of the flag, target and scope of the flag, and a good naming convention makes it so that both developers and other users in the platform can look at a flag and intuitively understand the purpose and be able to look at the description and easily understand the scope of the flag. It's also important to note that while the name of the flag in the platform can be changed after creation, the flag key that will be used in code is static and cannot be changed or duplicated. Our recommended naming scheme includes two main parts. The first is the action, which is generally a verb describing the higher level purpose of the flag, and the second part is the subject, which more specifically defines the scope of the flag. For example, this could be describing a new UI widget that's being released. Besides release, other common prefixes include enable, allow, show, and configure. The prefixes you use will be dependent on how you're using flags and what's relevant for your use case. But the most important thing is to internally document your naming conventions and ensure that they're being used consistently across your organization. When creating flags, it's recommended to use human-readable names so that anyone in the platform can easily understand the purpose of the flag, and to use the automatically suggested flag key, which is generated based on the name of the flag at creation. Since the flag key is static, it's not recommended to include metadata like team names or obscure values like ticket IDs and flag keys. You should also create intuitive names for flag variations, and when you do want to include metadata or external identifiers to a flag, tags are a good way to do this. Tags are also useful for leveraging in custom roles, getting metadata from webhooks, and filtering to create custom dashboards. When thinking about creating tags, make sure to clearly define and document their purpose internally, as well as using a consistent formatting like dashes, for example. You don't want to use the same tag to mean multiple things, as this causes them to lose their value, and try to use tags that are long-lived. If you find yourself frequently changing tags on a given flag, there's probably a better way to achieve what you're trying to accomplish. When getting started with feature flagging in LaunchDarkly, defining a naming convention and standardizing tag usage creates a structure that simplifies usage of a platform and saves time for your team members. And documenting these decisions is crucial to making sure that other teams are able to understand flags and maintain consistency as you continue to scale the implementation across your organization. Thank you, and I hope this was helpful.